All right. All right, we're calling to order the Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund Board Meeting for January 9th, 2024. Roll call and approval of minutes for the October 10th, 2023 Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund Incorporated Board of Directors Meeting. Jan, will you call the roll?
Director Rowan?
Here.
Director Halagus?
Here.
Director Granger?
Here.
Director Street?
Here.
And Director Lucas is absent.
Item number two is the...
Motion for the minutes.
I would make a motion to approve the minutes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Of the October 10th meeting.
I'll second.
Call the roll, please.
Director Rowan?
Here.
Director Halagus?
Here.
Yes.
Yes.
I mean, yeah, I'm sorry, yes.
Sorry, I followed him. Director Granger?
We're like dumb and dumber.
Director Street?
Here, yes.
Motion passes 4-0.
Number two is audience participation limited to items on the agenda. Remarks are limited to 3 minutes. Do we have any audience participation for the Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund Board? Seeing none, we'll move on to item number three, which is approval of financial reports. These are balance sheets as of December 31, 2023, September 30th, 2023, and September 30th, 2022. Balance sheet statement of revenues, expenses, and changes, and cash and fund balance analysis reports.
I'd like to make a motion to approve the Panama City Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund balance sheets as of December 31st.
I'll second.
All the financial reports?
Yes, all the financial reports from the Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund.
Thank you.
Right.
Second.
Please call the roll.
Director Rowan?
Yes.
Director Halagus?
Yes.
Director Granger?
Yes.
Director Street?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-0.
Item number four is consideration to ratify this past quarter's activity related to the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund Incorporated. As background information, during the quarter beginning October 1, 2023 and ending December 31st, 2023, the activity recorded in the fund consisted of $18,602 and expenses of $73,378 for the benefit of the after-school assistance program, $20,897 of interest revenue, and $45 expenses and bank fees. Staff recommends ratification of this activity.
I'd like to make a motion to ratify the past quarter's activity related to the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund Incorporated.
I'll second.
Please call the roll.
Director Rowan?
Yes.
Director Halagus?
Yes.
Director Granger?
Yes.
Director Street?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-0.
Number five, consideration to engage Carriggs and Ingram to prepare the necessary documentation to reinstate the nonprofit status of the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund. As background information, the Panama City Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund Incorporated inadvertently lost its nonprofit status for failing to file the appropriate annual tax returns for the past 3 years. This engagement will provide the necessary documentation to reinstate the nonprofit status of the fund. Staff recommends approval to engage Carriggs Ingram to prepare the necessary documentation to reinstate the nonprofit status of the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund.
I move to engage Carriggs and Ingram to prepare the necessary documentation to reinstate the nonprofit status of the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund.
I'll second. Jan, do you have something in place that's going to prevent this from happening again?
Me. Yeah. I don't know what happened. I don't know if the attorneys were doing it before, whether the auditors were doing it. It just fell through the cracks. But we've sealed the crack.
Yeah. That doesn't happen.
Yes, sir.
Please call the roll.
Director Rowan?
Yes.
Director Halagus?
Yes.
Director Granger?
Yes.
Director Street?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-0.
Item number six is consideration to provide additional funding for the After School Assistance Program, ASAP, for fiscal year 2023 from the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund. As background information, on March 14th, 2023, the city directed the proceeds from the sale of assets obtained as a result of a plea agreement with Michael Johnson to be used for the benefit of the ASAP program. During fiscal year 2023, the cost that exceeded the amount of funding available for the program was $238,778.04. This request is to provide the funding necessary to pay for the additional cost of the program from the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund. Staff recommends approval to provide additional funding for the after-school assistance program for fiscal year 23 from the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund in the amount of $238,778.04.
I would move that the for approval to provide additional funding for the after-school assistance program for fiscal year 2023 from the Panama City, Florida Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund in the amount of $238,778.04.
I'll second, but I'd like to make a comment too.
Okay.
The only thing I'd like to, I mean, we accrued those funds. I know that our kind of thought process in the beginning was building a physical facility, making improvements that are capital assets. I just want to make sure that, like, you know, at some point in time, I'd like to be able to say to people, this is where that money that from the sale went. And when it goes into program expenses, it's much more difficult to say that. So I don't have an issue with this, but I just think that we need to get that capital spent.
Right. There was $1.9 million in that account right now for the benefit of ASAP. The problem is these funds are being spent from the CDBG program, and the program doesn't cover the ASAP program, only like 40% of the program. So next budget year, the commission will need to sit down and determine how much they're willing to spend on this ASAP program. It's always been funded by the general fund previously, but that was under past management. So this is something that
it's been subsidized by the general fund.
And I will say, Terry does a fantastic job. I would just like to try to find a partnership that we possibly could help in engaging with. I don't know whether that's Boys and Girls Club, whether that's some other entity, Early Childhood Coalition, so that we have an ability to kind of absorb this without having to, you know, dip into reserves or carve out budgetary money to it. So I think now's the opportune time to do it, because there is so much money that's there. Yeah. If we need a transition, we can do that. So, but I want to say that's not reflective of Terry. She's fantastic. And hopefully we find a way to continue that program as well as her staff.
And I know the director, Sheila Ware, is working on that as well.
We have a motion and a second. Please call the roll.
Director Rowan?
Yes.
Director Halagus?
Yes.
Director Granger?
Yes.
Director Street?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-0.
Item 7 is confirmation of officers. I believe we do this annually, and this is to remove myself as president and put Jonathan Hayes on the board.
I'll motion.
I'll second.
Just kidding.
All right, call the roll.
Director Rowan?
Yes.
Director Halagus?
Yes.
Director Granger?
Yes.
Director Street?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-0.
All right. Item 8 is audience participation, open to any issues related to City of Panama City's authority. Remarks are limited to 3 minutes. Are there any comments for the Hurricane Disaster Relief Fund? Okay, seeing none, we will adjourn.
You're right.
Meeting.